innovation from Volkswagen, the 2016 Passat. It's more dynamic, styling, the redesigned interior with upgraded materials, and a whole bunch of new driver's assistance seat features and systems. And for the first time on the Passat Model Year 16, a host of new connected features, all for a great value. And I see young ladies smiling at me, and you would like the smartphone integration, I can tell you. Now, I'm happy to announce that for the first time, this is the Golf R-Line, the Passat R-Line. So for the first time, the Passat family will have a very sporty model at a very, very attractive price, below $25,000, by the way. So let's take a closer look at the Passat. I will start with the front. Slimmer headlights, more substantial four-bar grille, and you see here on how the chrome goes around. No, I have to stay here. I'm too excited with the car, I'm sorry. And the new hood gives the Passat a more dynamic feel. The premium look and styling carries around over to the rear of the Passat, for instance, now with standard full chrome window surrounds. The car has a new rear bumper, entirely new rear bumper, trunk lid and tail lights. For instance, these rear reflectors are completely new. You see the diffuser, you see the lights, and you see this very cool chrome stripe, which makes the whole car sit a little bit better and, from my point of view, looks a little bit premium as well. And for the first time available on the Passat, LED front and tail lights. A little bit late, but we are there and they look beautiful. These provide better lighting performance with reduced energy consumption, and they just look great. The new 2016 Passat gets a much more premium look and feel, and has a completely refined interior. Upgraded materials, new dash, new steering wheel, two-tone decor panels, refined chrome, piano black trim, and so forth. The new instrument panel features two large gauges and a center stack that presents Volkswagen second generation, and now we get to this modular infotainment platform that's called MIB, like Men in Black, but I'm just kidding now. So the 2016 Passat has standard touchscreens, full color displays, and the whole systems are much, much faster and higher resolution. Touch sensor similar to smartphone and tablet technology, enabling gesture controls like swiping or pinch zooming. USB Bluetooth connectivity are also standard, so finally the brand Volkswagen moves to USB in this market, which is already an achievement. So this serves as the foundation of Volkswagen available CarNet. CarNet is one of the best systems for connected vehicle services and features available in the automotive industry today. For instance, crash notification. For instance, the dealer can send vehicle health reports to get the right things done in service. And it includes our latest App Connect technology, which features the three major smartphone integration platforms, Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, and MirrorLink. And this is how App Connect allows seamless integration with more than 90% of available smartphones in this market. And I can tell you, one of my sons has a Samsung, I have an Apple, and we are both excited on how it really works. It's great. Which is not in the script up there, by the way. So, for the new Passat, it offers a whole combination of new drivers and driver's assistance systems, and this will take some time to read this off. Automatic post-collision braking system, standard on all Passat models. The system helps by applying the brakes after primary collision, helping to reduce the change of additional damage. We are confident that we will get top safety ratings with this car. Furthermore, Passat models come equipped with the following advanced driver's assistance system: adaptive cruise control, forward collision warning and autonomous emergency braking, blind spot monitor, rear traffic alert, lane departure warning which actively steers the car back into the lane. So I don't suggest you text while driving, but for the rest it's much safer. Under the hood, the Passat maintains all the proven powertrains, the TSI, the TDI, and the V6. In addition, it continues to have class-leading interior space and trunk. This vehicle will hit the showrooms in the end of the last quarter of this year, or in the middle of the last quarter. And I'm happy, very happy to say, that the Passat has made a very affordable entry price at exactly the same level as the Model Year 15 Passat. So, 1.8S automatic starts at $22,440. That's exactly the same price as the Model 15 without all of these features, but everything in, the customer gets additional value per car of minimum $1,200. And now you can accord. So, and looking at this great car, and looking at those great cars there, you know, it's built by Americans, in America, for Americans. And I would like to put this really into perspective. You know, the United States is very important to Volkswagen. We have more than 5 million customers on the road driving our cars. And more than 5 million customers are visiting our Sherwitz workshops every year. Our dealers, you know, 650 dealers in this country, have over 30,000 employees. Our suppliers, another 10,000 people here in America. And we have more than 6,000 employees in our facilities in Virginia, Tennessee, Michigan, California, wherever. More than 50 locations which we have here. And this is a great responsibility. And we must do this in order... No, you're too fast. You have to scroll back. And all these people, whether it's our customers, dealer families, our employees and their families, depend on us to run a successful business here with high ethical standards. And we must do this in order to carry out our responsibilities to all of our stakeholders. My commitment, first and foremost, is to make sure that our entire company does what it takes to resolve this big challenge and to restore your trust. Our future depends on turning this into an opportunity to learn, to improve, and we are damn committed to do so. And I'm confident and I'm personally committed that this company will do what it needs to be done to make things right. To make things right. And, you know, on a personal note, when I was 18, my first car was a Golf. And the stereo was more valuable than the whole car. Then I bought a Golf convertible, then I bought a GTI. Then I went to the US to study and live here. And now I'm back 25 years working for this company. And you can be sure that we will continue not only to correct this TDI issue and to straighten things out and to pay what we have to pay, but we will continue to work very hard to make our story here in the US for the customers, our dealers and employees a success story. Thank you very much for coming. Enjoy the evening. Up next is Lenny Kravitz.
I'm Manager of Product and Technology Communications at Volkswagen of America, and I'm here to introduce the 2016 Volkswagen Passat. This car is really important and significant for Volkswagen because it's built in our Chattanooga, Tennessee plant, and it's designed for Americans and it's built by Americans. Now, the new 2016 Passat takes the existing car, but we've got a whole host of changes. Specifically, under body, there's a lot of work being done with the sheet metal in order to try and meet the latest safety standards. Then when it comes to the sheet metal itself, we have a much more aggressive look. We have a new domed hood. We have available LED headlights and LED tail lights. We have a new 4-bar grille. Pretty much every single panel in this car has been changed. We also have, for the first time, a sporty R-Line derivative that has its own signature front bumper, its own side skirts, different diffuser, and it has 19-inch wheels. So we like to think that emphasizes like the sporty nature of the car. When you look inside the vehicle, we have a new instrument panel, we have new gauges, like binnacle gauges, we have a new steering wheel, new column stalks, and we have a new 6.3-inch touchscreen infotainment system. And that's really significant on this car because, you know, two of the key things that we have are really good connectivity and infotainment, and we also have a whole host of driver assist systems that haven't been available before. So when we look at the connectivity, we have a system called CarNet, and in that system we have what we call AppConnect, which is a system whereby we integrate all the major current mobile phone, smartphone platforms. So that's Apple CarPlay, Mirrorlink, and also Android Auto. And it's a very intuitive, very easy to use system. The actual touch screens themselves, when you get to higher trims, have gesture controls and things like, you know, you can swipe across to go from one area to another in the menu, which is very much more like a tablet rather than the typical touch screen you get in a car. So again, we've got a lot of new driver assist systems, and we also have one new standard safety system, which is called the automatic post-collision braking system. And basically what that does is if you're involved in a collision, it applies the brakes so you don't get involved in a secondary collision. And it's kind of unique in the industry. And then when you look at the actual driver assist, we have adaptive cruise control. We have what we call forward collision warning with autonomous emergency braking. We have an actual active lane departure system. So in other words, if you're straying from the lane, the car will take over for a short period of time and pull you back into the lane. And we also have a self-parking system we call the parking assistant or park assist. And that's pretty cool because it allows you just to take your hands off and you can either parallel park or you can actually park in a perpendicular space. So the car's full of technology. And the other thing about it is that we've added a lot of new content to the car, but even though we've added that content, we've kept the pricing pretty much steady. So the car starts at $22,440 for the base S model with an automatic transmission, which is exactly the same as the automatic transmission base model of the outgoing car. So value story is better. The car, I think, you know, obviously I'd say this, I work for Volkswagen, I think the car looks more planted on the road, more dynamic. But inside, we've got a whole bunch of technology we haven't had before. And I think your customers are going to like that.
We'll be right back.